Alright, what's going on you guys? Nick here with Nick's Drink and Power, back with another video today, and I've got a couple of interesting stories for you guys. And as always, I just wanted to say that I hope you guys are staying safe and healthy throughout everything that's going on right now. I'm still safe, I'm still healthy, and I really hope that you guys are too. I know they're saying right now that like over a third of the world's population is on lockdown right now. So a lot of you guys are at home, probably most of you guys watching this are stuck at home. You can't go to work, you can't go to school, you can't go to the restaurants, you can't go to the bars, you can't go to the store, you really can't go anywhere. So you got to go to youtube.com/Nick Strength and Power. So please give this video a thumbs up if you're enjoying the daily coverage throughout this entire, you know, crazy situation that we have in front of us. So enough about that. Let's go ahead and dive straight into the first story that I have for you guys today. And it's going to be a Big Ramy story. Now, as you guys know, Big Ramy missed the mark at the 2020 Arnold Classic. He did not come in as shredded or as lean or as detailed or as separated as many people wanted him to see, and he wound up taking third place at this year's Arnold Classic. So recently, on his Instagram, Big Ramy leaked some of his prep photos from the 2020 Arnold Classic. Now, the photos that he posted on his story here are dated March 3rd, 2020 and March 4th, 2020. So the show that week of March was on Saturday. So the first time that you saw him on stage for prejudging was Saturday, and that was March 7th. So this was 3 to 4 days out from actually seeing Big Ramy on stage, the earliest being this back photo, which was March 3rd, 2020, and that was Tuesday prior to that Saturday. So several days out, and he looks like he's in pretty good shape. And a lot of the people that were sending me these stories, because typically that's what happens, is a lot of people will forward me these stories and say, oh, you know, look how lean Big Ramy was, look how detailed he was, what happened before the show, why did he not look like this on stage on Saturday? Now, of course, the one thing that needs to be considered here before anything else is the lighting. We all know the stage lighting and the lighting in your hotel room at the best possible angle is going to make you look completely different. And while I do agree that his conditioning looks better in these hotel room pictures than it ended up looking on stage, I do not think his conditioning looked insane a couple days before the show. I do think it looked better, and he looked, you know, he looked more depleted. So as a result of that depletion, he had a little bit more detail to his physique. But I don't think the pictures that we're seeing here are like a night and day difference from what we saw on stage to what we're seeing in these prep photos. And maybe that's why Big Ramy posted them, because he did think there was a night and day difference. He wanted to show people, look, you know, I looked pretty good right before the show. Because we already know what he looked like on stage, so there'd really be no point in him sharing these pictures from before he got on stage unless he's trying to show us that there was some contrast between how he looked on stage and how he looked right before he got on stage or a couple days before. Now, we know that on Thursday, March 5th, his coach did an interview. His coach, Chad Nichols, did an interview with Ron Harris of Muscular Development where they're talking about the process of getting Big Ramy ready for the show, and they're talking about the carb up process for the show and trying to fill Big Ramy's physique out, and saying that he got up to 310 pounds during that process. And I believe they said he gained something like 9 pounds throughout that process. So my guess in this scenario would be these photos were taken before the carb up process, before the fill up process. In particular, the Tuesday picture on March 3rd, that to me definitely looked like a depleted version of Big Ramy. So this could have been before they tried to fill him out and he gained, you know, almost 10 pounds or more than 10 pounds or whatever it was. But when they were talking about it, it was a pretty drastic carb up process, a pretty intense one. So yeah, I do think from a conditioning standpoint, from a detail standpoint, Big Ramy looks better in these hotel pictures than he looked in his stage pictures, but that's to be expected. And again, you got to factor in the lighting and the angles, and you know, you really have the prime choice really of how these pictures are going to look. Whereas on stage, you don't really control any of those external factors as to how your picture is going to look. Now, that being said, it's worth pointing out that these pictures were posted on his story. And there was also a picture that he posted directly to his feed and then deleted immediately afterwards. And this was, luckily I had a lot of people sending me screenshots of this because people screenshotted it as soon as he posted it. He was hitting an abs and thighs pose. Now, I don't know why he deleted it. There were some people that were sending me this, pointing out that there was like a weird dark spot on the left-hand side of the photo in his lower abs, like a weird dark line. And to be honest, I don't really know what that is. It looks kind of like a Y shape. I'm sure you guys can see it. It looks kind of like a dark vein. So I don't know why he deleted the picture. I don't think it looks horrible. I do think if this is a completed crunch down abs and thighs, the separation and detail in his abs really isn't that good in this photo. But it's interesting. And a lot of people say, well, why do you keep talking about Big Ramy in these videos? Obviously, he's never going to live up to the hype. Well, I wanted to keep talking about Big Ramy in this video in particular because honestly, it looks like the way that this bodybuilding season is going, this might be the last time that we see Big Ramy on stage in 2020. I want to remind you guys that Big Ramy did not qualify for the 2020 Olympia by his third place placing at the Arnold Classic. So, unless he has the opportunity to compete at another show again, and a lot of those shows have been canceled already, I think there's a high probability this is the only time we're going to see Big Ramy on stage in 2020. I really think the rest of the bodybuilding season for 2020 is going to be severely impacted. And someone like Big Ramy, bigger physique, he takes a lot of time to prep and get down, and he's got to travel. It's going to be hard for him to have another show between now and the Olympia and qualify for the Olympia, so he might shut it down. We might see Big Ramy shut down everything for the rest of the year. And honestly, that might not be a bad idea. But let me know in the comment section below what you guys think about how Big Ramy was looking and what you guys think happened between then and the day of the show on Saturday. Now, next up in the news, let's talk about Hafþór Bjornsson in a recent video he posted on Instagram where he's deadlifting 400 kilograms for not one, but a triple. And 400 kilograms, to you Americans out there, it's about 881 pounds. So he did this amount of weight for three reps. And as you guys know, he was in preparation to try to break the all-time world record, which is 501 kilograms. That would be the new world record. And that would be an 1104.5 pound deadlift. And that would be to beat Eddie Hall's deadlift world record. Now, the interesting thing here is, well, the sad thing here really, is the fact that this competition that he was getting ready for was the world's ultimate deadlift competition, which was going to be next month. This was going to be in Bahrain. And there was a $100,000 cash prize to the man that was able to deadlift 501 kilograms. So this was really what he was training for. This is really where he had his sights set. And this is where the 501 kilogram deadlift was supposed to be attempted. And this is really the best opportunity for it to be attempted was this show. Now, unfortunately, due to everything going on in the world and these current health concerns, that event has been postponed indefinitely. So it sucks for someone like Hafþór, and it sucks for the fans too, because obviously everybody wants to see a new world record. Everyone wants to see a world record get broken. And Hafþór had been adjusting and planning his training accordingly to this competition that was coming up next month. To get that 100 grand and to get that deadlift world record. So who knows how he's going to have to adjust his training because they haven't announced the new date. We don't know when this event is going to happen or if it is going to happen this year at all. And again, I've said this in other videos. I think that's the scariest part about all of this is the uncertainty. You know, when is this going to be over? When are things going to go back to business as usual? When are these events going to be back on? You know, when are we going to be able to leave the house again? I mean, in my state, Ohio, and in a lot of states already now, we have a shelter-in-place, stay-at-home order. You can't even leave the house unless it's absolutely essential, unless it's like an absolute emergency. So I think we're still a long way away from major events like this, you know, happening, getting rescheduled, getting planned. And even bodybuilding, you know, the Olympia says it's still going to go on as planned. But I think this is the only competition that I think the competition that has the best chance of still happening is Athleticon, that Icon World Classic, the Rocks bodybuilding show. That is like the biggest show, the latest in the year, in October, like mid-October. So I think that has the best chance of any show to be the show that still happens, especially when you consider the fact that we found out it's an invitation-only show, and that Athleticon, you're looking for an invite. The Icon World Classic, you're looking for an invite based on their criteria. The Olympia is a show you have to qualify for. So even though the Olympia is still on, a lot of guys have not been able to qualify because there's no shows to qualify for it. Now, I did want to mention here, because I haven't talked about this before, but the Olympia did announce they will be extending the qualification window pretty much as late as they possibly can. So the Olympia weekend is going to be September 10th through the 13th, 2020, and they're going to be extending all Olympia qualifiers through August 29th to try to give guys the maximum opportunity to qualify for that show. But again, we have no idea, you know, when these shows are actually going to be allowed to happen, when everything is going to be business as usual again. And again, we're still left with the dilemma that the Olympia is a show that you have to qualify for. So I think right now, you know, Athleticon, is in a prime position to be maybe the best show of the year because they can invite whoever they want, really. I mean, the Olympia, technically they could extend special invitations as many as they want, but the first ever Athleticon, Icon World Classic, they could change the rules, invite, you know, change the rules for their invitation, the invitation standards. They can invite anybody. And because they are pretty much the show latest in the year, the biggest show latest in the year, I think they have the best chance of going forward. So I just wanted to point that out. And I know it's not really news to you guys because you guys know by now pretty much everything is off. Everything is canceled. But I did want to show you guys that video of Half Thor because it looks like he might have been getting close to getting to that record and breaking that record. And that's something that we're not going to see now in the next month. Now, the final story that I have for you guys today, I think this is a good one. Now, Valuetainment in the past has posted several very fascinating, kind of explosive bodybuilding interviews, and their latest one is no exception to that. They had Dexter Jackson on the show primarily in response to some of Sean Ray's comments about Dexter Jackson, specifically where Sean Ray was talking about how Dexter would not even place top six at the Olympia in his prime, specifically at the Olympias that Sean competed at, saying Dexter now would not place in the top six of those Olympias. But I'll get to that in a second. One of the things that they talked about, because I was just talking about Athleticon, is whether or not Dexter would compete in Athleticon, because obviously, guys, you guys heard, you know, the announcement earlier this year that Dexter Jackson was going to be retiring at the 2020 Olympia specifically. The 2020 Olympia was supposed to be his last show, but he says a couple of interesting things in this interview, which appears to be recorded after the Arnold Classic. So it looks like in this interview, they're talking about first, they're talking about Athleticon, and Dexter initially says he wasn't planning on doing Athleticon because the time gap was too much between Athleticon and the Olympia. He was thinking it was a couple of months, and in reality, they told him, look, it's just 4 weeks, and Dexter said, he basically said he's kind of thinking about it. Well, then Dexter also went on to kind of throw a hint in there that he might not be retiring at the Olympia. He's still going to be retiring in 2020, but he talks about the Prague show that's a week after the Olympia, and with everything that's been going on, apparently they're putting a lot more money into that show, prize money, to get athletes to compete. So he kind of says, you know, he's kind of been considering that. So if he weren't going to retire at the Olympia and go on to do Prague to get that prize money, you know, maybe there's a possibility he's going to do Athleticon still. But basically, the gist of this interview is that Dexter goes on to say now that he knows when Athleticon is, he's considering it. So I got to give props to the interviewer here, Patrick Bet David of Valuetainment. He's done a good job, really. I mean, for a guy that runs a channel that really doesn't have anything to do with bodybuilding, he's done a good job of drawing out some good information from these bodybuilders in this interview, so I did want to give him props for that. And then also Dexter goes on to basically say he would destroy Sean. If you take Dexter in his prime versus Sean in his prime, Dexter says he weighed 230, Sean weighed about 205. He says he would destroy Sean. It's not even close. And now that was the big takeaway for me from this video, but also, of course, Athleticon. You know I love to talk about Athleticon, so that was cool to hear. I'm going to give you guys one more story, though, just because I want to, you know, spice this video up and give it a little bit more depth to it. Callum Von Moger, I'll make it quick. People were sending me this screenshot from Callum Von Moger's latest video because a big topic of conversation has been his legs. Obviously, another thing that got canceled was the show that Callum was planning on doing, the Jay Cutler Desert Classic. That was going to be Callum's big return to the bodybuilding stage. Callum's not doing that show, and he did show an actual side-by-side of his legs in his most recent video titled Moger's Muscle Mansion. The screenshot was taken at 8:38, where you can clearly see the full quad of both legs and how atrophied one leg was compared to the other following that patella tendon tear injury that he had. Gosh, I don't even know how many years ago that was now. But yeah, so you can definitely see the imbalance in his legs. He probably wasn't ready to compete just based on where we're seeing his legs at. So it might have been a blessing in disguise that this show did end up getting postponed, I guess, as of right now. It's not entirely canceled. It's probably going to still happen at some point, but not anytime soon. So that's going to wrap it up for the video today, guys. I hope you did, in fact, enjoy it. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed already. I know you guys are bored. I know you guys are stuck at home. I know you guys are looking for something to watch or keep yourselves entertained, and I will keep posting for you guys as long as this whole situation just keeps going on, man. I know it sucks. I know it's boring. I know it's stressful. I'm right there with you. I'm going through it. I'm going through a breakup. I'm stuck here alone in my house, just like all you guys. It sucks. So subscribe to my channel because I'm going to keep you guys entertained. And as always, Nick Strength and Power, signing out.